partners should all be working together the same way.
No? Cool. Yay. Yay.
If everyone wants to put their kids on the east side, it seems like we should be working harder to keep our kids together.
Those people from Morgan City don't want to drive down to Clackamas. People from Clackamas wouldn't want to drive to Oregon
City. But it opens up those fields. You'd have all the fields to be open up.
Well, yeah, and then you can have a, like, Eastside is thinking, because I have a friend who coaches on Eastside.
Yeah.
They're thinking of doing they're actually kind of strategizing, kind of like what she's, you know, Trish is talking about.
Yeah.
They know that they're getting a lot of kids from Valley, from Happy Valley.
Uh-huh.
And then there's some other kids that may want to, but they don't want to drive all the way over there. So they're trying to think geographically and having a north and south team.
Yeah.
Where some of the teams who practice at the Happy Valley field.
Uh-huh. Well, they've already kind of taken that field
doing
over.
Right, I'm just saying that there some of the kids there are from that area or are willing to drive. Oh, get there, I'm gonna get there. Oh.
Well, and they're joining forces with us in Portland.
Right.
Timbers is taking up.
Right.
That's gonna be three clubs competing for fields in the same area.
Yep.
Three clubs united, that would open up Oregon City Fields, Milwaukee Fields, and Cockburn.
Why are we talking about strategy about soccer?
I'm just saying it would be nice to have all the clubs working together. So you've got three or four classic players to Oregon City, and you've got five or six kids in the Torrance age. All the clubs join together.